Now that I've had a few opportunities to chat with folks, let me just tell you that the reason I'm doing this is because I've been called to do this by my friends, people who've known me for many years. And a little background again, I was born and raised in Cuba. My parents sent me legally alone to the United States when I was 12 years old. Why? Because Castro was conscripting children into the militia. The first thing that any totalitarian government does is separate the children from the parents. They want the next generation to not know anything about the previous generation. They want to erase the history, so they have to change the minds of children, literally. And that's what Castro was doing. I was marching in parades in military uniform, and I was 12 years old, 11 and 12 years old. That's what they do. So my parents saw that, and parents saw that in Cuba, and they sent 14,587 Cuban children to the United States, to Mexico, to Canada, to Spain, alone, with visas and passports and everything, and I can show you my passport and my green card and all that, to get them out of Cuba during that period. Now, then my parents joined me and all that. And then, fast forward, my parents, starting with zero, nada, nothing. You have never been at zero. The people in this room, we're blessed. Unless you have some very strange, you have never been at exactly zero. No place to live, no money, no car, no nothing, no job. We were at zero. My parents were. And my parents have passed on, but they achieved the American dream. And yes, you can. There's a process for doing that. It's called the success sequence. And I will be teaching and talking about the success sequence. But there has to be, in order for sexy success sequence to work, there has to be a stable form of government that's based on principles for governance. And we have had that for over 200 years in the United States. But there's some people who don't like it that way. And they're trying to tear it down. They're working very hard to tearing it down. This invasion by 8+ million illegal aliens, that's the right term. They're not undocumented migrants. They're not migrants. They are illegal aliens. Illegal aliens. I will not back off from that term, because that's the correct term according to the Immigration Reform and Control Act of 1986 that I have been enforcing as a human resources professional since 1986. It's still true today. Unless they change that law, they cannot change the term. And I will not change the term. We are being invaded by millions of illegal aliens because they want to change how we live. The people who are in favor of sanctuary cities, illegal aliens, debit cards for illegal aliens, free healthcare for illegal aliens, all of those people are in the same tank, which is that they want to shake the foundation of our nation such that they can do things their way, regardless of law, regardless of constitutional constraints, regardless of anything that you have thought was the right way to do things, okay? So that's what I'm up against. That's what we're all fighting. That's why we feel stressed, because it's happening right in front of us. And then they say, oh, no, there's nothing. There's no high crime. These illegals are, you know, you should be sympathetic about, you know, they're coming over here. No, they don't belong here. Hello? They don't belong here. They belong where they came from. And there are 12 million other people who are trying to get here legally, and they're being prevented by the same system that's allowing the illegals to come in. Those are facts. You can look them up. I did a presentation in September at the Pittsburgh Library on this topic. I have a PowerPoint slide deck. I can send it to you, and you can send it to anybody you like, that I presented in Pittsburgh Library in September. It's about 35 slides, all about this topic. That's just one topic, okay? I'll shift to another topic off the top of my head, the so-called ERA, which is really a law to divide parents from their children. Remember what I said about Cuba? The Albany, I'll just say Albany. Albany, because there's some people in there who are not Democrats in Albany. Albany is trying to change things such that parents will have no agency over their children. Agency means, and the judge just left, she can explain this better to you. Agency means you have control of your children until they're 18, by law, by president, by principle. but they're not happy like with that in Albany. They want to give the agency to third parties. Who are they? Teachers unions, people with political intent, medical people, without your consent. This affects my grandchildren. It may affect your grandchildren or even your children if you're young enough. So that's just item number two that I'm fighting against. And the judge mentioned one thing that she's involved in, and I know people who are involved in that too. She mentioned children and foster children and all that. I wanted to exchange a name with her of somebody like her who has also 12 or 18 children. I lost track. The same way as the judge, as Judge Bailey. And that lady that I'm thinking of created a home. It's called the Margaret House, a home in East Rochester for pregnant women in distress. And she funded that. So my point is that there are people doing great things for our community and in our nation. So we have to not just complain about the bad stuff. We have to also put forward some positive things, okay? So I am here for legal immigration. I am here for public safety to put criminals in jail where they belong. But first you have to fund the police. You have to support the police. And first responders, my son is a first responder, he's an EMT. So we have to support those organizations that are like specifically first responders in this case, who are trying to help our community. Instead of talking about defunding the police, instead of talking about pretending that there's no crime in the streets, instead of pretending that illegal aliens are here, you know, and we should be sympathetic. No, I am sympathetic for the 12 million who want to get here the right way. Mm-hmm. Amen. And I could go on with more details about that. Like I said, I did a whole two-hour presentation on that. So the point is that each one of these topics that I just touched on lightly have huge depth. And I could go on. I could stand here for a long time, and you don't want that. You want to get to your pizza. But the point is that I want to present, and I will as my campaign proceeds, I want to present for you positive goalposts and positive objectives and positive results that we can get with people like Judge Bailey and with, her name is Paula with the Margaret Home. Just a few topics, and if you have any questions, I'll be happy to accept them.